properties of light. Among all of the natures and properties of light, we'll go through reflection, refraction, total internal reflection, interference, polarization, scattering. Reflection is the change in direction of a wavefront at an interface between two different media, so that the wavefront returns into the medium from which it originated. In the picture, the angle of the incident ray theta I is equal to the angle of the reflected ray theta r. The incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal all lie in the same plane. These are the two rules of reflection. Refraction is a change in direction of a wave passing from one medium to another, or from a gradual change in the medium. In the picture above, the direction of the incident ray is changed as the refracted ray. When the light ray is coming from a less dense medium to a denser medium, the refracted ray bends towards the normal as shown in the picture. Again, when it comes from a denser medium to a less dense medium, the situation becomes opposite. The refracted ray bends away from the normal. We can get a picture of that situation if we rotate only those three red arrows of the ray to their opposite direction. The incident ray, refracted ray, and the normal all lie in the same plane here as well. Total internal reflection needs the concept of critical angle of two medium. In the picture, the green light ray is passing through the denser medium glass to the low dense medium air. Here, the angle of incidence is always less than the angle of refraction. That means there must be an angle of incidence less than 90 degrees for which the angle of refraction is 90 degrees, and the refracted ray will travel across the interface. That angle of incidence is the critical angle. The red light ray is an example of this. Now, if we increase the angle of incidence, there is no scope of refraction. What will happen then? While traveling from denser medium to a less dense medium, when the angle of incident ray becomes bigger than the critical angle of the two medium, the light ray is then totally reflected at that interface with no loss of brightness. This is called the total internal reflection. The blue light ray is an example of total internal reflection. Actually, we see the mirage and the rainbow for the total internal reflection of light. When two waves meet together, two things can happen: constructive interference, destructive interference. Constructive interference occurs when the maxima of two waves which are in same phase add together, so that the amplitude of the resulting wave is equal to the sum of the individual amplitudes. Equivalently, the minima of the waves would be aligned. Destructive interference occurs when the maxima of two waves are 180 degrees out of phase. A positive displacement of one wave is cancelled exactly by a negative displacement of the other wave. The amplitude of the resulting wave is zero. The straight line is the result of a destructive interference. When two light waves from different coherent sources meet together, then the distribution of energy due to one wave is disturbed by the other. This modification in the distribution of light energy due to superposition of two light waves is called interference of light. Both of the constructive and destructive interference is occurred in the main interference of light. In the picture, when the crests of two waves meet together, the blue dots, then constructive interference happens, as well as when the throughs of two waves meet together, the yellow dots. It causes the line of maximum displacement, the yellow lines. The places straight to the lines become bright. Again, when the crest and the trough of two waves meet each other, the green dots, destructive interference happens, and those places remain dark. This whole thing creates an interference pattern as the upper picture. This type of experiment is called the double slit experiment. It was first performed using light by an English physicist, Thomas Young, in 1801 as a demonstration of the wave behavior of light. A whole picture of that experiment with the interference of light is shown below. Here, the light wave has been passed through the single slit. When it reaches the double slit, two different waves are produced from the previous one.
Finally, the interference of light happens and it creates an interference pattern in the rightmost barrier. Light is an electromagnetic wave as well as a transverse wave. A transverse wave is a moving wave whose oscillations or vibrations are perpendicular to the direction of the wave. In the picture, the oscillations of magnetic field and electric field of the electromagnetic wave is perpendicular to its direction as it's a transverse wave. When a beam of light comes towards our eyes, the electric field could be oscillating horizontally or vertically or diagonally or even in all possible directions. The light coming from above could be an example of beam of light. A light wave that is vibrating in more than one plane is referred to as unpolarized light. Polarized light waves are light waves in which the vibrations occur in a single plane. The process of transforming unpolarized light into polarized light is called polarization. Unpolarized light can be polarized by using polarizer. A polarizer is an optical filter that lets light waves oscillating in a specific direction pass through while blocking light waves oscillating in other directions. In the picture, the unpolarized light is coming towards the polarizer and it's being polarized by the polarizer, which makes the light to oscillate in one direction and the light becomes polarized light. The light wave was oscillating in various directions, but after being passed through the polarizer, it oscillates only vertically. If a second polarizer, which blocks light waves oscillating vertically, is placed after the first polarizer, then there will be no light waves passed through the polarizers and the barrier will be dark. When a beam of light falls on an atom, it causes the electrons in the atom to vibrate. The vibrating electrons re-emit the light in all directions. This is called scattering. Scattering of light depends on its wavelength. The wavelength chart of light is shown below. The shorter the wavelength of the light, the more it will be scattered. The chart of scattering with the wavelength is shown below. In the chart, the percentage of scattering is increasing from red light to violet light. This is because the red light has the longest wavelength, where the wavelength of violet light is the shortest. This is the picture of scattering of blue and red light. As the wavelength of blue light is shorter than the wavelength of red light, it scattered more than red light. This is the reason of bluish sky during day and reddish sky during sunrise and sunset. During noon, the sunlight needs to travel a short path to reach our eyes. Though blue light is scattered more, but some blue light are able to reach our eyes before it has been scattered away. So we see the bluish sky during noon. On the other hand, during sunset or sunrise, the path becomes longer. As a result, all the blue light scattered away before it reaches our eyes. But as the red light is scattered less than the blue light, some of them can travel all the way and reach our eyes, which makes us to see reddish sky in that time.
Thank you.